But what is happening in North Borneo should not affect the peace talks because North Borneo is not part of ARM. So, walang problema, di ba?
No, but it's the role of Malaysia, apparently.
But you know, aren't we big enough or small enough with big brains in order to understand that if Malaysia facilitates their, is a facilitator? But that's one problem put on one side. The North Borneo is a proprietary problem between Malaysia and Kiram.
Yeah, that's true.
Ours is a sovereignty problem between the president of the republic and Malaysia.
Okay.
So now they're saying that as a conspirator, that we are hindering the peace talks. That's another pronouncement of Malacanang. Come on, you know, hello, wake up. You know, this can be done, you know, on a separate basis.
So what?
You know, like if Malaysia is an intermediary, why do we have to meet in Malaysia? Why can't we meet in ARM? You know, why do we need a foreign country to come when this is our policy? If sila Kagi Murad already decided, you know, and they were like referees, you know, Malaysia is a referee, that 1899 Kiram-based treaty allowed the Americans to come in, right, in the letter of Salamat. So therefore, yung letter na nga, invited the Americans to come in the foreign country, you know, to be all part of the peace process.
Oh my God, you're a freaking expert in this. Okay, wait, I'm going to ask you, what should Pinoy do now? Is there still hope?
I think this little pretty mini of an auntie, you know.
What do you think?
Who studied all of this culture.
So what should we do now?
And history. There should be a ceasefire.
Pinoy should call for that. But the Malaysian Prime Minister said no more negotiations. Remember
But Pinoy is the president of the Philippines and the president of the Muslims and the Moros. You know, he should.
So is the right
now
word...
Now this keeps me mum.
Is the right word ceasefire instead of using the word surrender?
Unilateral ceasefire and exchange of prisoners.
Really?
Yes.
Unilateral ceasefire. This is your... Okay, can you expound on that? That's interesting.
Okay.
Let's see.
On a ceasefire, the Philippines will have... will lay down their ammunition.
The Royal Sultanate Army.
Yes.
You mean?
Yes. And also the Malaysians.
Okay.
Because if... I was on my way to Tarlac and I could hear bang, 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 and it was the cell phone of the Rajamuda who was in Malaysia, and they said, sniper, sniper. And I said, who fired first?
You know? Yeah, you wouldn't know
right.
anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they claim that the Malaysians fired first. I would say, oh my God, my Muslims, you know, my Filipino blood, you know, they're being fired upon. You know, so I would, you know, ask, you know, send immediately somebody within an hour to Malaysia, you know, and clarify the matter.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But now you also have prisoners, so you have to have the release of prisoners. We Filipinos release our prisoners back to the Malaysians. Malaysians give us back their prisoners.
Oh, very interesting.
Yeah.
Huh? Okay, because I think Fatima had said that they had allegedly 10 prisoners?
Yes.
10 Malaysian prisoners?
Yeah, 10. So why not exchange?
Yeah.
That's the beginning of goodwill, to sit down in a square, triangle, round, octagonal table, whatever it is, you know, but it's a start.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.